Hello world, it's Rani again here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create CRUD system with VB.NET and MySQL database. If you're not familiar, CRUD is an acronym that stands for Create, Read, Update and Delete. And this is a video series, so I suggest you to also watch from the first part. I'll include the link on the description. We created combo box binding in the previous video, so let's delete this part first. Also, remove code that provides the function. Then, up here, we'll create a toolbar for the buttons like save, edit, delete, etc. Using these two strip components, double click, then it will get into the top of the form. Now add 5 buttons like this. I want the button to display image and text, so I'll choose image and text display style. Do the same for all buttons. Then, modify text for each button with text that represents the function. To set the image icon, click on the button, then set image. We'll import image from a file. Here, I have some icon set to be used with PNG format. For save button, I'll choose this floppy disk, click open and OK. Do it to the all buttons. Now, all the toolbar buttons already have image and text. Also, to make it easier while coding, change this button's name to represent its function. Done! Move the grid so we get space to add the input controls. I add a group box to be filled by the input controls. Name it GRP input. Tidy up a bit. Change its text into input or edit. For the data grid view, set anchor on all sides so its size will be adjusted while the form resized. Add two labels. And two text boxes. Change the text of label to be code and name. Then name the text boxes to be txt code and txt name. I widen the name text box because name usually longer than code. And here is the last code I made. I'll move code under form load event to a new procedure named data load, so it become reusable. Just cut and paste it here. Then we call the data load on form load event like this. Move these three variables into the data load so it will be refreshed every time we call this procedure. Next, setting some properties of this data grid view, and I will gather this code by the with syntax. We won't let user to add and remove data directly on grid. So set allow user to add row and allow user to delete rows to be false. Also, the data grid read only equals true for preventing edit. After that, setting header text, which is title of each column. Then set columns width to make it look better. Okay, let's try to debug. Now we can see it's much tidier. Next step is saving process. Double click on save button, then event code automatically generated. Declare a command to run insert and update query. Set connection con as a new connection and use our previous connection string. Let's just copy paste. Add try catch for error handling. Open connection. Then type the insert query. Class code value is taken from txt code and class name from txt name. Set my comment connection to cons. Comment text to SQL. Then run execute non-query. This type of execution used when we don't need any return value. Below, we add a message that informs saving new data is done successfully. Clear text on txt code and txt name. Then call data load to refresh data that display on grid. Add message under catch if there's error occurs. And con.dispose after finally. Again, let's run debug. Try to input new data, fill category code and name. Then click save. The success message appears. Click OK. Newly added data is displayed on grid. Next step is creating edit and update process. I'll explain in run mode. We'll edit data by choosing a data row that will be edited. Pick it by double clicking, the chosen data will be displayed on these text boxes. So first we need to write code for choosing in data grid view event. When we double click on data grid UI, event that automatically generated is cell content click. But I prefer using cell mouse double click so we can pick from the event list just like this. And yes, this is one of the advantages of VB.NET that we can easily pick an event by list. Remove this cell content click because we don't use it. Now we add code to display chosen row into txt code and txt name, like this. Set tbr edit to be disabled while editing. Also, txt code is set to be read-only because it's a primary key that better not be changed. Edit button will have similar functionality, so we can call grd data cell mouse double click from tbr edit click event. Fill parameter with nothing and nothing. Try to run the bug and let's see how it works. When we double click around, then its data will be displayed in the text boxes. Let's move to cancel button. Its function is for clearing all input control and refresh grid display. Double click on it and write code like this. This code is clearing input text boxes. Then set edit button to be enabled. Text box of code read only equal false so we can put data on it again. Call data load procedure to refresh data grid display. We've already made code for cancel button event. So we can substitute this code in tbr save click by calling tbr cancel click procedure. I'll copy paste and fill the parameter with nothing and nothing. Let's step ahead. We'll write code for updating process, which is saving data for all change made. We should modify in saving event here. We've already got a query for insert new data, so we'll add an update query. Let's use tbr_edit.enable as condition to differentiate as we made it for editing process. While data is being edited, tbr_edit.enable will be false. Write update query under else here. We change the name only since code is primary key. We use class code in where clause. Keep the other code like try catch finally as is. We'll only modify on message part with if clause just like insert query before. Each process, insert and update, have their own message after process is done. We've already got for the insert, so here is for the update. Finish for this part, let's try to run the bug. I'm gonna pick the last row and double click it. Try to modify the name. Then click save button. When it's done, a message will say data has been modified. And the data grid displays the modified data. keep on moving, guys. Now we are making delete process. Double click on TBR delete UI, then TBR click event automatically generated. Before we actually delete the data, give a message box to confirm if user really want to delete it. This is just in case delete button is clicked accidentally. Create message box like this. With message box style yes no, and set its title confirmation. Result of a message box depend on button that user choose or click. Yes button is the one that should be clicked to remove data, otherwise removing cancelled. Here inside of the if clause, create a new MySQL command named my command. For the connection, we still use the conf variable and copy paste the connection string. Try and catch as error handling. Open connection, then create SQL query delete for deleting data. Deleted data is row that selected on grid with class code as primary key to be used as where clause. We can get selected row with syntax grddata.currentRow and get class code value by cell index 0. Setting my command connection to con, command text is the SQL delete. Then execute non-query. Below we put a message, data deleted, that will show after data deleted. Then call tbr cancel click to refresh all input control and display in grid. Let's just copy paste from here. And give parameter value with nothing. Don't forget the connection close. And add error message for catch exception. Finally, under finally, we put con.dispose. We almost there, guys. The last button is close button. Double click to generate TBR close click, then put me.close for closing form. And let's run the bug. Delete this category Z by selecting it and click delete button. First, a message box will prompt and we'll choose yes to delete. Deleting done and message of data deleted appear. Click OK, then data on grid will be refreshed. The category that just deleted no more displayed on grid. And last, let's try the close button. Click and form closed. That's it, guys. This is the longest tutorial I made until now. I hope you learned something. Happy coding and bye!